A friend of ours. I'm here on behalf of her. So this is a short introduction to the TeX package. So Susanne Raab is the author. I am the spokesperson. So Susanne starts her talking by sending a message to all of you and telling that she would like really much to come here and enjoy the meeting with us, but sadly she could not come. So instead the ducks had to come here by themselves. So I kindly agreed to give this talk on her behalf. So that's it. So Susanne, if you're watching, hello, and we miss you too. So let's go with the introduction. just to clarify something, I did not do the slides. It's hers, so I do not take responsibility on the content. Okay, right? So as you probably know, rubber ducks can be made of latex, right? And by the way, we are probably the biggest producer of latex in the world, in the entire world. So the question I pose to you is, but can ducks also be made of latex? The answer, of course, is no. Who in their sound mind would do such thing in latex? Well, in fact, you can. You can with the TeX package. Someone might argue that this is far too silly. But behind the funny beat, there's serious code involved here. There's key vol implementations. There are path transformations. Eric and I were talking about this package. She contributed a lot to the package. She drew a lot of ducks. And she told me that she learned a lot from this package because you started to understand a lot of internals, a lot of path transformations. So behind the amusing subject, there is serious coding involved. So let's go. How everything started? Of course, someone out of her mind, it was Carla Maggi, who asked this in the tech community exchange. So as we usually do there, when a question leads to a package, we sign it here. So TeX became as the result of an answer for this question. So let's see how we do it, how we create a duck. First, we simply include the package. We create a TeX picture. Then inside it, we just issue duck. And voila, we have a very nice duck. And if you are a fan of TeX libraries instead of proper packages, because of course TeXducks loads TeX by default, you can use it as a TeX library and draw it using the picture. So then you have a duck. So it's not just that duck you can have. You can have much, much more. So let's see what we can achieve. Through a very simple key-value interface, you can customize many parts of the duck. So in this case, you have the body in color blue, you have the head in green, you have the bill in red, and you have the eye yellow. There are some keys that have default values, so if you not provide them, it will default to the value, the predefined value. And we also have predefined add-ons. So let's say you want your duck to have a top hat. So you simply write duck with a top hat. Oh, but then you say, no, but I want my top hat to be in another color. So that's no problem at all. You just simply say top hat equals red. Then you have a very nice top hat in red. OK, this is a TeX fashion, as she likes to say it. This duck is actually Princess Peach from the Super Mario World if you the Super Mario universe, if you know, if you open the manual, you will find Princess Peach, you find Mario, and you find Luigi in the documentation. If you are a video game player, you recognize the ducks. Well, we also have some hairstyles to the ducks. So we have a variety of them. And of course, each value here you can set up the color. So let's say if you want a brown hair, or if you want a dark hair, you simply pass the color. So that's, we have a couple of hairstyles. Of course, ducks need to wear clothes as well. So we have some presets here. You can have a t-shirt, you can have it a jacket, you have a cape, and then you can combine things like this. You can have a tile, and you have a nice executive duck in that sense. Of course, hats are important. Barbara already told us the importance of hats. So in this case, we can have it. Lots of hats, including the one I use in my avatar. I think Joseph's duck is missing. It's probably good, nice feature. And there are some crowns as well. I think it uses some chess font for that. And well, some of us wear glasses, so we do believe ducks should wear glasses as well. So we have three types, basically. We have the round glasses, we have the square glasses, and sunglasses that are for ducks who like to go to the beach. Well, ducks can also express things. So you can make it hold a signpost. So in this case, it's just saying quack. And you can make it speak. And of course, you can make it think, because of course, ducks are very smart. And we also have the sports section. So we have cricket, which is our favorite sport. We have hockey, and we have football, right? And here, she included, let's say, I would like to say it was a Neymar duck, but he's not rolling. So it cannot be said as him. So here there's the color of our jersey, right? And then we specify the parts. Look that for the jacket, she provided a more advanced TikZ comment. So she provided these stripes here, which she used to do the lower part here. As to emulate a short. Here we have some examples. In this case, it's a Juventus duck. It's a tribute to Enrico. And we have Mönchengladbach duck, which is a tribute to Ulrich and Gertz.
Thank you.
Oh! Oh, and did I say it correctly? Oh, that's nice. Oh, and of course, ducks can be very sophisticated. In this case, this was entirely made with TeX, and TeX ducks. Of course, ducks need to eat as well. So we have some things on the menu. It's probably not as much as rhubarb as we had yesterday, but we can have like pizza, ice cream, milkshake. We can have baguette. We can have cake, and of course, a very fine wine. Well. Let's say you want to generate a random duck from all the presets. So you can do that. You just issue a random duck, and you can get any sort of duck combining the elements in the predefined package. Well, it is of course a TeX picture, so you can interact with all the elements. So in this case, Susanne just put in that coordinate a rectangle of that size. But she provided also some hooks in which we could use, like head, bill, tail, and wing. You can use those coordinates like an alias to write more advanced drawings. Let's see some examples. So this is all year round. So we have an Easter duck. We have some Halloween, I believe, a winter, and Christmas. This is all done with TeXducks. We also have farm animals. So we can have a sheep, we can have a donkey, and a bit more. And I believe we have some Star Wars fans here. So come to the duck side. And I believe we also, so live long and prosper. And we have, this is for Tom, we have a scout duck. And I'm not sure if you could read it here, is scouting for ducklings, holding a book. So Susanne also presents something she calls a duckification. So let's take someone we know. We have here our master, Donald Knuth, and he is holding a signpost that's from, this picture is from the March for Science that happened in the United States. I don't remember exactly the yes, I do believe so.
I tried to sign, they didn't allow me because I was not American.
Oh.
Not a scientist.
Well, Don was there marching, and of course he makes a joke with huge. I think I don't need to explain. Well, I can explain in the coffee break. So what we need to take some elements like colors, which parts are important for us to reproduce it. So once we have that. Of course, we can get some other shades. Then, well, we are almost there. So we reproduce the colors in our ducks, in our duck. Sorry. Then, there we just duckfied Don Knuth, and there we have it. It's very nice. So let's see some TeXducks users. This is from a Japanese user of TeXducks. I don't know why, but he put it a sushi. Not sushi. It's a, I don't know the name of that. Yes, maki on the top of the duck. Probably using the hook we know. This is from the World Cup final. It is Croatia against France. So we have the ducks there. We also have some works of art. This is from Alexander Graham. Let me show you the real thing. It's not aesthetic actually. It's this. Wow. He did that entirely in tech. And by the way, I am in the boat behind. And if you, I love this detail. You see the little one sometimes drown. See? I'm gonna leave for you to see. Oopsie. And there we go. Now let's go back. This is a wacky talk. And for those who sign the tugboat, you're probably already seen him. In the column, there is now a column named Duckboat, written in Tugboat. This is Professor Van Duck. He's a duck who helps people. He tries to introduce tech concepts to new users. So it's a fantastic column. I believe there are two columns so far, and I recommend you, if you have your issue, take a look and read it. It's fantastic. And this is the real doc. This is the real professor. He is in Milan and wearing the cap of our conference. For this particular talk, Susanne did a surprise for us. She made, with Yurik as well, she made a rendition of a very famous Brazilian song by the name of Aquarela. Aquarela is a song by a composer named Toquinho. Toquinho released this song, I believe, in 1983. And it talks about how you use watercolor to paint on a piece of paper and create art, things from your imagination. I remember my generation, and I believe most of the Brazilians here, because we are I know we have younger Brazilians here, but this was a fantastic song, because it proposed that you have to be creative, you have to imagine things. And I have the video here. I will finish the slides, and if you all agree, I can play it for you guys to see the video. And we also have more videos. This is a fantastic contribution to the TikZducks packages. It was called the Great TikZduck Christmas Extravaganza. It is a lot of short videos featuring ducks in wacky situations to show the power of the package and also in tech, because modulo the transitions, the more complicated transitions in the video, everything was done with LaTeX. So it really shows the power of our beloved engine. Here's the International Pizza Day, and we also have a Happy Groundhog Day. Well, we also have friends of TikZducks. If you do not like TikZducks, you can have TikZ Marmots. We had a bit of discussion with Suzanne, and we told her that we also need TikZ Zoo, because that's what we are going to have pretty soon. So this is a nice marmot. Okay, problems and ideas. TikZducks is already included in TechLive and MikTech, is already in Satan and on GitHub. So if you find something wrong, you can write to her. Oh, she is also very active in the tech community of Stack Exchange. And you can suggest her to add more ducks, to improve the package. And can I play the video?
Yeah.
Do you mind?
Okay.
Okay, just a minute. Let me plug.
Is it 3 minutes?
It's I believe it's 4 minutes.
And please put all the others on your webpage.
Oh, it's already online.
Somewhere is everything online. Just like the TUG homepage.
Okay, I'm gonna play it, guys. Let's see if it works. There's the Portuguese and English lyrics for you.
Uma folha qualquer eu desenho um sol amarelo. E com cinco ou seis retas é fácil fazer um castelo. Com um lápis em torno da mão e me dou uma luva. E se faço chover com dois riscos tem um guarda-chuva. Se um pinguinho de tinta cai num pedacinho azul do papel. Num instante imagine uma linda gaivota voar no céu. Vai voando, contornando a imensa curva. Norte e sul, vou com ela, viajando Havaí, Pequim, Istambul. Pinto um barco a vela, branco navegando. É tanto céu e mar, um beijo azul. Entre as nuvens vem surgindo um lindo avião. Rosa engrenar, tudo em volta, colorindo com suas luzes a piscar. Basta imaginar e ele está partindo sempre. E se a gente quiser, ele vai pousar. Qualquer eu desenho um navio de partida.
com alguns bons amigos, bebendo de bem com a vida. De uma América a outra eu consigo passar num segundo. Giro um simples compasso e num círculo eu faço o mundo. O menino caminha e caminhando chega no muro. E ali logo em frente a esperar pela gente o futuro está. E o futuro é uma astronave que tentamos pilotar. Não tem tempo, nem piedade, nem tem hora de chegar. Sem pedir licença muda nossa vida e depois convida a ir ou chorar. Nessa estrada não nos cabe conhecer ou ver o que virá. O fim dela ninguém sabe bem ao certo onde vai dar. Vamos todos numa linda passarela de uma aquarela que um dia enfim descolorirá. Uma folha qualquer eu desenho um sol amarelo que descolorirá. Com cinco ou seis retas é fácil fazer um castelo que descolorirá. Giro um simples compasso num círculo eu faço um mundo que descolorirá.
So thank you very much, gentlemen.
Oh? Yeah. Could you move to the slide 4 of your desk, your deck?
You mean remove?
Slide 4.
4. Oh, sorry.
I think you go there.
Could you go to slide 4?
Let me remove.
It's in the beginning, yes.
Here,
you see that you make rubber ducks from Hevea brasiliensis.
Mm-hmm.
And what make me really sad is you take TikZducks, apply Hevea with them, and you will not get neither valid HTML nor accessible HTML. And
oh, I see.
Very bad.
I see exactly. Well, I do believe there's some work for improvement.
Just to point out that TIX can make SVG, so you should be able to generate SVG versions.
So you need to do it right.
It should be doable.
Yeah.
So you are more than invited to help us write the code, Joseph.
We also have PDF to SVG.
Let's call it version 2. Yeah. So?
I just hope we covered by fair use.
Oh, I see.
So
thank you, guys.